For God is everywhere. He is there, He is here, He is everywhere. That is should be the conception. Therefore, in our Hindu religion, when you get up in the morning, when you say earth, our earth is there, from there our food is coming. Everything you got. All material we are using, our cloth, this thing has come from where? From cotton. And cotton grows from where? From there, from the food we eat. All the metals we are making, the cars and aeroplanes and all these, from where? The petrol is coming from where? Gold and this and all these things. Everything from earth. And should you not be grateful to when we, more than mother she is mentioning that. So, Mata, Bhu Mata, so salutation. Similarly, sun, from which we are deriving, and also air. If air is not there, if oxygen is not there, you won't survive even 3 minutes. So we do tomeva sakshat tvam brahmasi. Addressing wind god, we say, far as direct god you are, because without you I can't survive even 5 minutes. Similarly, without water, how long will you live? Without food, so evidently everything is there is some divinity everywhere. Therefore, in gratitude we send it. Not knowing the secret, they are criticizing these people, they are saluting the stones, worshipping. Do we worship stones really? When I do, what is my conception? What is my thought? Because God is everywhere, but I want to offer something. Where do I offer? When you want to give something, the person must be there. So I can offer. When the concrete form is there, so I offer. But what is my thought? In my mind, I think the God only there, not stone there. No doubt, I myself brought the stone from the river. I myself chiseled also and kept it there. But when I worship, my thought would be about God only there. Very basic thing. There is a photo there. So let us say your grandfather's photo. So what is it? The only paper, is it not? The paper, some painting. But do you think it is paper only? My grandfather, when I was a child, he took great care of me. He used to take me a long walks and feed me. So, and he taught me Ramayana. And so all those things come. The attitude of prayerfulness comes to him. So you can't help worshipping photos. You can't help worshipping idols. But thought would be same thing. Gratitude one, and also the divinity. God is there. So that is why in our religion, God is everywhere, and we practically we do it. When you do it only, you can see that also. When you bring all the, because of that faith, you bring wonderful, all fresh flowers you bring, and nice preparation, naivedyam for offering you bring there, and you burn agarbattis and the dhoopa and all these things. Why do you do it? There's so much devotion you do it. So the attitude of devotion, you want to express. How do you express? So this is an outlet for expressing Christ. Therefore, this ritual, in ritual, this idol worship and image worship must be there. Very concrete we want. But we are doing God only. God is, you can't see Him. So we have to create one God. Of what form? What is our form? Human form. Therefore our God also, we create something like that. Maybe we have got 2 hands, we put 4 hands here. Yes, that is it. Vivekananda Swami said, if a buffalo were to meditate and think of God, it would be a big buffalo. So like that, we should begin from there. It is not that we will be confining like that. So, we can't help it. As being a human being, our God also will be like us. We are kind, so our God must be kind. We are impartial, we like impartiality, so God must be impartial. Isn't it? We are blissful, happy, so our God must be happy. We have some power, so God has more power. So like this, you can't help a human being, you cannot help. And you are condemning idol worship. When you identify with your body, what are you doing? You are spirit. You are spirit. All filling is spirit. But you confined to one body, which is perishable, are you not doing the same thing? Idol worship, idolatry. So you are idolater only. And who is not idolater means one who knows, realizes the truth. Then he will not think I am in the body or I am the body. Idea of course. I become impersonal, not personal. So as I become impersonal, my conception of God also becomes impersonal. Then he will not be any person. But any saint who realizes truth, he sees only non-real entity. So therefore, his conception of God also changes totally. He is no more a person. Like me. Only he is out of idol worship. One who knows the truth alone will not need. But otherwise, we all need it. When you in Islam, you know, they condemn our and they break also our murtis. But what are they doing? When they do namaz Kaaba, that's stored there in the temple there. Makkah. So they turn towards that and they do namaz. So Makkah is there and Quran Sharif there, holy book is there. What is that holy there? It is also paper and printer. But what is the conception? It is a holy Bible and a holy Quran. We say holy Bhagavad Gita. This is all idol worship only. And the crescent moon. They worship, they look at the crescent, they do namaz. Is it not? So that Kaaba is there, one masjid is there, and Hajj, go to for your pilgrimage all the way to Makkah, Medina, and there also take bath in the dirty water, also they say holy water. So many if you see, is nothing but that. So it is ingrained in our nature. Christianity also they say they are against. But why the cross? Where also cross? Everywhere, building also one cross. And also Maria. Not only Christ is holy, but Mother Mary also, Mary also is holy. Her Bible is holy. Is it not? So, if you see every religion, basically they are doing some ritual or other. You cannot get rid of, we cannot remove that thing. That is the basis for us. So, with that, when you worship your idol in this thing, so that your mind will be in a mood of devotion, emotion, devotion. Thus slowly divinity will come to you. That is the basic thing. Like kindergarten, if you go, you learn the alphabet there and the letters there. Later on you add them and you read books also. But can you say nowadays we have highly advanced. Therefore let us abolish kindergarten and primary school and middle school. Let us go to university direct. Can you do that? So you cannot do it. Similarly, meditation is the last stage for us, realization. But how do you come to meditation? So only when you do all these rituals, and then puja, devotion, offering, when you do that, and then slowly the thought of meditation will come to you. So it is a growth actually. And it is the necessity always. It may not be necessary for you. You are outgrown, never mind. But there are others for whom it will be there. That's so, and you can see those who worshipped idols also became great saints. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa worshipped what? Kali Mother in the temple. And he was asking, Mother, are you really present here? If you are there, then why don't you reveal to me? He was talking to the idol. And day after day, and crying and weeping, and ultimately he came to the pitch. He thought, now today, he brought one big sword. And he said, Mother, either you show yourself, or my head goes now. He took the sword and he was about to strike. But suddenly the illumination came to him, like Narasimha Bhagavan talking about. The sword fell and he fell into superconscious state. He was ultimate conscious. So when you come to nature, it will reveal that God is there also. It is not, God is not there. God is there everywhere. He is there. But our capacity to see him is not there. If you say, water is there, there are so many living organisms. With your naked eyes you can't see. But you bring a microscope, you can see thousands are floating there. Similarly, when you develop that your spiritual eye, you got physical eye now. If you develop spiritual eye, then you can see these secrets. Atma's realization will come. So that it is represented by Shiva's third eye. We have got two eyes, but Shiva's a third eye. But we also will develop that third eye. That is a spiritual eye, we have called Samadhi, in Samadhi, superconscious state or intuition, we say, the different words are there. So, like that, similarly prayer, you can say, is prayer. Every religion advocates prayer. In prayer, what is it? A direct communion with God, direct talking to Him, not begging. Oh Lord, give me my daily bread and all. This is small things. But we pray so that my mind may be illumined, my light may come, I become holy. That is the real prayer. And this prayer, whatever form it is, never mind. So, even if you worldly things, you can ask, but your faith is there in God. So, it is there in Bhagavad Gita, he says, Artho Jignasu Ratha Arthi Jnani Cha Bharata Shabha. He says, four kinds of people come to me. That Artha means one is in great trouble. Suppose one is physically, mentally afflicted. Then, oh Lord, then prayer automatically comes. Similarly, you are ignorant, people call you fool, you don't know anything, so you want to acquire some knowledge, jignasa, desire to know, also you pray to the Lord. And artharthi, you want money also, you pray to the Lord so that remove my poverty. Doesn't matter, even you are asking small thing, but yet your faith is there in God, so it is some, you are on the right line. That is what Bhagavan Krishna says. Even if they come to me when they are in suffering, when they want something, a worldly thing, doesn't matter. They are better than the atheists and the agnostics. They have faith in them, and one day they know their mistake and they will clarify, let me not ask the Lord about these small things. Then give me pure devotion, sir. Give me, reveal thy true form. Our Guruji Maharaj, we are very composed the song. Jai Jai Vithala Panduranga, Jai Hari Vithala Panduranga. Panduranga means Lord Krishna. So Jai Jai Vithala Panduranga, Jai Hari Vithala Panduranga, Jaganivasa Panduranga, Jagatpate Panduranga, Anadyananta Panduranga, Amala Vimala Panduranga, Sarvantaryami Panduranga, Sarvantaratma Panduranga, Vyapak Vibhu Panduranga, Amala Vimala Panduranga. The different qualities of Lord Krishna. Then, in English he composed, Thy name is a boat, Panduranga, Thy name is a boat, Panduranga, to cross this samsara, Panduranga. If I want to go beyond birth and death and suffering, so it is crossing a big ocean. For that you need a boat, you need a ship to cross. And this is your name, if I repeat the Lord's name, Krishna, Krishna, Rama, Rama, so mind becomes pure and one day realization comes and I become immortal. Therefore, thy name is a boat, Panduranga, to cross this samsara, Panduranga. Thy name is a weapon, Panduranga, to destroy this rakshas mind, Panduranga. My mind is devilish, creating all kinds of troubles for me, delusions and hallucinations. So, to destroy that, your name is like a weapon, atom bomb, it simply destroys me. Thy name is a weapon, Panduranga, to destroy this rakshas mind, Panduranga. I am pining for thy grace, Panduranga. I am thirsting for thy mercy, Panduranga. You is your grace, your kindness. I am pining for thy grace, Panduranga. Pining means great longing, great desire. I am pining for thy grace, Panduranga. I am thirsting for thy mercy, Panduranga. Reveal thy true form, Panduranga. Let me behold it, Panduranga. Please, you reveal your true nature. I don't know what is your nature. It is beyond my capacity. Only if you are kindly, you will show what you are. Satchinananda Swarupa or whatever that is. Reveal thy true form, Panduranga. Let me behold it, Panduranga. Let me fix my mind, Panduranga, at thy lotus feet, Panduranga. Let me fix my mind at your feet. Let me utilize this body, Panduranga, in thy sacred service, Panduranga. Let me not live selfishly for myself. Let me utilize my body in the service of you, in so many names and forms. Let me utilize this body, Panduranga, in thy sacred service, Panduranga. This is my fervent prayer, Panduranga. Do not forsake me, Panduranga. Panduranga, 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 Panduranga. Thou knowest everything, Panduranga. Thou doest everything, Panduranga. Thou art Dharma, Panduranga. Thou art righteousness, Panduranga. Thou art my soul refuge, Panduranga. Thou art my father guru, Panduranga. My father guru, Panduranga. Thou art my very prana, Panduranga. Thou art my very life, Panduranga. Pratyak Chetana, Panduranga. You are my innermost self, conscious self. Paramartha Tattva Panduranga. You are the highest, ultimate truth. So, Jai Jai Vithala Panduranga. Jai Hari Vithala Panduranga. So here prayer, we are talking. So prayer should be, you reveal thy true form. That is the request. And let me surrender myself completely to you. So this prayer is there in all religions. You can see this. It is very natural, the prayer. And one question we can say, now we say karmati is there, prarabdha is there, the theory of determinism, everything is determined already, you can't change anything at all. And karma theory also almost looks like that. Whatever you do, you get the result and you can't escape from it. So then, is there anything called God's grace? God also seems to be going according to laws, so he has created laws. If you do good, good result. If you do bad thing, punishment will come. But where is the scope for God's grace? But we talk of God's grace in all religions. Every religion talks of God's grace. Gracious Lord, the adjective itself is like. So can you do that? Can God be really gracious? But if he is gracious to all or to some? If he is gracious to some, he is a partial gentleman. He should not be partial. So, how do we understand this sense of grace? The point is, who created the world? Did you create? You did not create. I did not create. Such a huge mountain, river is so majestic. Is it a human production? No. So some all-powerful, all-knowing, omniscient, and omnipotent, omnipresent God only must have done it. And if he had created the world, do you think he has no freedom if you want to alter something? Even the people who make constitution law, even if the king wants, let us say, nowadays the kings are not there, but even the king is there, he can, according to his whim and fancy, he can change. So similarly, you think God is bound himself, that he can't be, he has no freedom to do, so if he feels something. Even the Supreme Court, you know, since the Supreme Court, so many judges, they sit. And from the lower courts, the case comes, ultimately it comes there. And all the judges sit together and they give a judgment. Now, there is a chance you can appeal for revision of the judgment. Sir, you all people have given judgment, I am not satisfied, kindly have a second look at it. So they will again agree. They will again see. And this time they change their own judgment, they set aside and then give new judgment. So when the judges can do this, and even if supposing judges do it, it can go and appeal to the president, and president can change, he can show his mercy. So if this thing is possible, then God cannot show his grace? He must be, he's all powerful. And he himself made the world also, rules also. Why he cannot change? So God can change. But when does he change? That's the question. When you pray to him, when you repent also for things you have done, what are these things, prayer and repentance? Is it karma or not? Is it not action? You are praying, is it not action? And every action must bring the result also. So it is logic there. So when you pray, when you appeal, petition, why do you petition? If there is no response, do you petition to anybody, any officer, any president or anybody? The petition is looked into and then response will come. So we are petitioning to the Lord, praying to him, so the result must come. So according to my karma, let me say, I fall ill. But when I praying, what happens? So that result also must come to me. So God will inspire somebody to come and serve me. And also bring some doctor also will come, medicine also will come, money also will come. So this will come, so it will reduce the amount of pain which I have. So the karma, bad karma was there, so this is king. But prayer is there, repentance is there, so God will send, this is the grace. So he will send, inspire somebody to come to help to you. And also God can do something else also. He will give you the moral strength. What is that? This is spiritual, I am spirit and I am not body. So let me not care for this. This is that mental attitude also changes. You become strong. This is the experience of the people who are religious and spiritual people. Let that be their body, after all the pain is there, doesn't matter. But I am not the body. I am Ananda Swarupa. So that inner moral strength also will come to you, apart from the outside help. So thus God's grace is there, and God's grace does come. And what is our experience, you can see? Anyone who prays with all fervor and devotion, with a total surrender, you can see God comes running. If you take 4 steps towards God, he takes 10 steps towards you. The saints have written this. It's not any bluffing or anything. And if you have no faith, you experiment and see. So it is possible. God can do that. But where is God? The question is not where is God, where is not God? He is within us. He can inspire, he can give light here also. You can help, bring help from outside also. Therefore grace, the theory of grace also is right. So our prayer, our ritual, these are very basic things. Some people say, in this modern time, people have no faith. It is enough if you are moral, if you are good in nature, they say. But no, even if you are moral, even if you are kind, even if you have knowledge, but you will not have the feeling of satisfaction unless you do practically something, worship. Practical ritual, if you don't do it, you will not be there. It is necessary. It is like, paddy seed is there. The paddy seed, paddy, you understand? Paddy means when your husk is removed, rice. It's called paddy. So if you throw the husk, can it germinate? Husk is necessary. Although it is not worth, husk is worth nothing from our point of view. But if the husk is removed, it can't grow, it can't germinate. Similarly, in religion, you cannot abolish ritual. It is necessary. From there only the sense of concrete will come. Every religion has 3 parts, philosophy, mythology and ritual. Philosophy will give you theoretically that Atman is all pervading, consciousness, it is the eternal and all that. We have thought through some stories, so and so saint lived and he prayed and he got, some mystics are there, so some stories are there. Mythology, story of devotees, how they got knowledge, how they become blessed, how God showed his kindness, so many incidents, stories are there. It will be there in mythology. But practical will be the ritual. You need the ritual here. All the symbols are there. So practical, with your eyes you can see, with your eyes, with your hands you can worship, you can feel. So ritual cannot be given away. You develop morality, you develop spiritual things, but ritual is necessary for us. So that is why these are all common things. That is why you see even in ashrams, we say only Atma is there, Atma na Dhyana, but ritual also we are allowing. All the saints have done it. We celebrate all the saints, Krishna's birthday, Rama's birthday, and some kind of ritual. If you remove one ritual, you will substitute even a lower kind of ritual. Previously, when you want to take God's photo, and then a big procession would be there with all drums and playing, dancing, everything. Our temples were the places where dancing was there, singing was there, all fine arts were there only, painting also. Later on they declared independence. People sang before the Lord to please, not to please human beings. That was the devotion was there. So now what happened? Now let us say the materialism has come and secular knowledge has come. What is there? This is idol taking and going. They say no. But the president or the prime minister, we want to take one instead of going with God. Now we want to go with him, garlanding and then. This is the lower type, a mortal being you want, that is, God is far better than this. So some ritual you do want, even now. If you go to the parliament, so there is a protocol is there. Where will the president sit? And who will receive him and garland him? Who will sit next, right to him and left to him? They have a big protocol, there is a law there. If another country's president has come, so he should be made to sit at the right or left. Some such rules are there. So in the parliament system, it is karmaganda only, even though if you can see that. The speaker, what are his rights? Like in the school, the monitor controlling everybody, the speaker controls everybody. Mr. Right, honorable member, please sit down, he will say, and then you have to sit down. So ritual in some form or other we need, in life it is there. And even ordinary life also, when I meet you, how do I greet you? If I am an Indian, I will fold my hands and say namaskaram, I will tell you. Or I will prostrate otherwise. But in the West, with all shaking, your whole body and everything will be shaking. So in both cases, what are we doing? You are expressing the warmth of your love. Is it not? So this is also protocol. Similarly, dress also, you can see different dresses we wear. So the dress also is related. It is kind of one ritual only. In some temple, somewhere you can't go bareheaded. The sardars are there, they will not allow. You must put something on the head. That's the protocol they have made it. You can't go with the shoes into the temple. You must keep the shoes outside. So like that, Englishmen nowadays they all go and police. Good morning when you say take the hat. So these are all, what is it? This is a ritual. So this is necessary in life. Even in our life also we are some kind of ritual we keep, and it will remind us. The light reminds of the eternal light here. The form and other things also. Holiness. There is the atmosphere of holiness. If you come here, there is atmosphere of holiness. When you enter into temple or church, what is the sense of holiness? If you go into a court, so all the lawyers or liars are there, and the dispute and quarrelling and this thing only, that whole atmosphere will be like this. And if you go into a hospital, what is the sickness and medicine and smell, everything. So the place has got its this thing. Similarly, when you come to ashram, you will always singing there, bhajan, meditation, so atmosphere holy. We need all these things. Temples for what? Churches for what? To keep the place holy. So therefore, we are advised that if in your room, in your house, you set apart one small room for you, where you keep only your meant for meditation and puja. Don't allow others, people who don't believe God, and don't allow them. They will pollute it. So, to keep it. And whenever you go meditation, you go and meditate. Don't sleep there. Sleep, you go to the bedroom. But there you keep it like this, so that you can seclude there and you can feel. There will be a potency, power will be there. Daily you are, holy thoughts you are living there, so vibration will be there. So all this they have, our saints have seen. That's why they insist on temples and worship, rituals, all these necessary. Our goal is different. Ultimately you have to transcend everything. Puja and all this duality you have to go. But how do you go there? If you want to pass PhD, can you pass in 2 years to a PhD? After so many years, you have come from the bottom, then you can go to the PhD class. So similarly, our meditation and realization will come at the end. So all this preparation is necessary. That's why even our Guru Maharaj, you can see, he has written on everything, bhakti, jnana, and puja, and he insisted also, in our ashram we do all these things. We do. Go to Ramakrishna Mission, go to anywhere. So we are still clinging to our rituals, our prayers, our study, scriptural study, daily should be there. If you read newspaper, what happens, you find out? The whole world is in your brain, and which you cannot do anything at all. And there you say, so many died, so many accidents are there, so many other ways, some political upheaval is there. But what are you going to do? Unnecessarily carry all that rubbish in your mind, and you can't do what you want to do. Therefore, don't read Govinda, newspapers Govinda. Don't read Govinda, Ramakrishna House Govinda. Don't read Govinda, Herbert Spencer Govinda, Ingersoll Govinda. They will create Govinda, wrong samskaras Govinda. They will throw you Govinda in lower births Govinda. But study Govinda, Gita Upanishad Govinda, Brahma Sutra Govinda, Vivek Chudamani Govinda. They will create Govinda, Mogul samskaras Govinda. They will give you Govinda, Self-realization Govinda. Govinda, Govinda, Govinda Vaja Govinda, Govinda Vaja Govinda. God is Truth Govinda, God is Love Govinda, God is Infinity Govinda, God is Bliss Govinda. Attain this Govinda through Japa Meditation Govinda, through Likhita Japa Govinda, through Selfless Service Govinda, through Brahma Vichar Govinda. Don't take bribes, Govinda. This is bad, Govinda. This is very bad, Govinda.
This is way bad.
This is very, very bad, Govinda. Don't hurt, Govinda. Don't hurt others' feelings, Govinda. Don't insult them, Govinda. Don't be cruel, Govinda. Be kind, Govinda. Be generous, Govinda. Study daily, Govinda. One chapter of Gita, Govinda. Do charity, Govinda. 1/10 income, Govinda. So that is Swamiji said. What is truth? God is truth, love. And how to attain? Through japa, meditation, etc. And what we should not do, all bad things, you should throw away and cultivate good virtues, and don't read these rubbish things which will only spoil your minds. Read your scriptures daily, read your Bible or read your Bhagavad Gita. They will talk about what is the subject matter there. All this is spiritual only. Therefore, we should read them. So, this way, all round sadhanas are given in that ritual, worship also, puja. Every day you have to do the puja, maybe half an hour, maybe 5 minutes, 10 minutes, doesn't matter. Similarly, prayer, when you go to bed, can you not 2 minutes pray, oh Lord, give me light, I am going to bed, let no bad dreams come to me. You can do that. When you get up also, now I am going again into samsara, all day, kacha pacha, so many activities are there, humdrum, so kindly see that my mind is clear, you can pray when you get up. This much you can do. You can't say, I have no time. Where there is a will, there is a way. If there is a TV there, 2 o'clock till 2 o'clock, going on seeing. Is it not? TV interesting to you. Similarly, supposing these things are interesting, spiritual, so will you lack time? In between, while working also, Sita, Sita, Ram, Bolo, Radhe, Radhe, Sham, Bolo, there also you can sing a lot of singing. So, where there is a will, there you ample time will be there. So, that is only lame excuse. But what sir, I have no time. So, what is it? While time also, while doing gossip, how much you gossip, you can find out. Hours together gossip, and what is the subject matter? Same thing, because daily, husband and wife, lifelong they are talking only. What are they talking? Only household, this thing, she is like that, he is like that. Okay, let them do whatever they are there. One is not aware how much time they are wasting in idle gossip. Can you expect Govinda, real peace Govinda, if you engage in scandal backbite Govinda? So these are the things we are wasting our time. So the saint has found out all this, stop the loopholes, all that is given. So we must read the books written by such saints. At least that much we can easily do it, instead of reading some of these things. So I see they are purchasing newspaper, so many nowadays it is like book. And end to end they read. I don't know what is there, what they are getting there. Great thing. Either they are reading newspaper or they are going to sleep. I find even if go in the travel, in the plane or anything. So either they read something in newspaper and then they are sleeping. And when they get up, again read. They can never sit quiet, I don't know. I can't sleep at all. When something is moving, I doing myself in vijara. Who am I? What is my sarupa? It is a place for meditation. To move in a plane or train or anything. For them, the moment they get, they can't think anything at all. Only either go to sleep or read newspaper. Or if there are 2-3 weeks of gossip, then they discuss this thing, gossiping will be there. You see, the Prime Minister is very wrong. He should have not done like that. The Prime Minister, he is breaking his head. There he is working. What do you know about Prime Minister? That is his field, he knows better. He is not your work. You don't know anything there. So such foolish things and other things we engage ourselves. So all these things we should cut off. The negative sides we should have to go there. So, of course, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Shivaya Namah Om, Shivaya Namah, Shivaya Namah Om, Namah Shivaya. Shiva 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 Shiva, Shivaya Namah Om. Shiva 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 Shiva, Shivaya Namah Om. Hara 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 Namah Shivaya. Hara 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 Namah Shivaya. Jai Shiva Shankara, Hara Shiva Shankara. Jai Shiva Shankara, Shankara. Om Shiva Shankara Namami Shankara. Om Shiva Shankara Namami Shankara. Shambho Shankara, Shankara, Shambho Shankara, Shambho Shankara, Hara, Shambho Shankara, Hara, Shambho Shankara, Shambho Shankara, Hara. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya,
Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya,
Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya,
Om Namah Shivaya,
Om Namah Shivaya. Bolo Shankar Bhagwan ki
jai.
Shankar bola bhala, bada mat wala, bada mat wala. मतवाला है शंकर बोला भाला लॉर्ड लॉर्ड शिवा इज वेरी इनोसेंट बोला भाला शंकर भोला भाला But matruvala, spiritually intoxicated, always meditation is blissful. This is the description of Lord Shiva. Shankar bhola bala, bada matvala hai, hai nishkish, bada matvala hai. Jata me uski, chandrama viraje, jata me uski, chandrama viraje, gale me sarpon ki mala, oh sarpon ki mala, bada matvala hai, bada matvala hai. Shankar bhola bhala, bada matvala, bada matvala hai. There is crescent moon in his locks, and he is wearing garland of snakes, and intoxicated. Shankar bhola bhala, bada matvala, bada matvala hai. Jata se uski ganga bahaye, jata se uski ganga bahaye, pine ko bhang ka pyala, oh bhang ka pyala, bada matvala hai. The Ganges flows from his locks, and he drinks one cup of intoxicating drink, and already is intoxicated spiritually, and this adds to him. So madness becomes much more mad spiritually. Bada matvala hai, Shankar bhola bhala, bada matvala hai. Ango me uski Gauri ma viraje. So he is a consort, Parvati sitting nearby. Ango me uski Gauri ma viraje, god me ganapati lala, Lord Ganapati is sitting on his lap. God me ganapati lala, oh ganapati lala, bada matvala hai, bada matvala hai. Shankar bhola bhala, bada matvala hai. That is, there are things to disturb him, there is family and all this, but yet he is immersed in this divine ecstasy, and therefore he is our ideal. We want to become, in spite of our limitations in life, when we have to do so many duties, yet we can transcend, become like Lord Shiva. So we admire him, and we think of him, and he is innocent, and we also will become innocent. All crookedness, cunningness, you know, these things are bad in us. Kill this cunningness, slay this crookedness or cunningness. Kill this cunningness, slay this crookedness, then you will have self-realization. It is such things that is holding us, they are not allowing us. O children of light, will you drink not? Won't you drink not? The nectar of mortality. Ram 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 Jai Sita Ram Jai Jai Radhe Shyam. Ram 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 Jai Sita Ram Jai Jai Radhe Shyam. Draw the indriyas, still the mind, sharpen the intellect, chant Om with feeling, meditate on Atma. Chant Ram with feeling, meditate on Sitaram. Chant Shyam with feeling, meditate on Ganashyam. O children of light, will you drink not? Won't you drink not the nectar of immortality? Ram 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 Jai Sitaram Jai Jai Radhe Shyam. If you do this, he says, all karmas are burnt now. You have become a jivan mukta. That blessed state of Turiya, no words can describe. Highest state, you cannot describe your highest realization of it is. O children of light, will you drink not, won't you drink not the nectar of immortality? Ram 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 Jai Sita Ram Jai Jai Radhe Shyam. The grass is green, the rose is red, the sky is blue, but the Atman is colorless, formless, and gunaless too. O children of light, will you drink not, won't you drink not the nectar of immortality? Ram 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 Ram.